Hello everyone. In the last session we have seen how to place the equations into the proper canonical form, and also we have seen how to write the min term list as well as the max term list. The equations or the expression generated from the truth table are not simplified. Simplification of the expression reduces the hardware required for the implementation. Now how to reduce the expression? One of the method is to go for the Boolean algebra, but it becomes a lengthy process. Therefore, we use one more method. We study here one more method called as the Carnot method. Carnot method is nothing but it is the graphical representation, and through that we are simplifying the expression. Now what is this Carnot map? The Carnot map is the graphical method for representation and minimization of the functions. Each square represents the min term or a max term form of the Boolean equation. The arrangement of the matrix squares permits the identification of the input variable redundancies, which help reduce the output equation. We will see how to reduce it. What is the K-map? Let me share my desktop. And here, K-map we are studying for two variable, three variable as well as the four variable. Now what is the two variable K-map? Two variable K-map in the sense it consists of four squares, or you can say it as four cells. It means 2 to the power of 2, that is four squares. See here, this is MSB and this is LSB. So either way is also true. Here also you can write it as MSB, this side is the LSB. Accordingly, the decimal number or the cell position changes. Here, in this particular example, we have represented this as B as MSB and A as LSB. See, look here, since it is a two variable K map, we have four cells. So this first cell is decimal notation is 0, or decimal number or the decimal equivalent of the first cell is 0. Decimal equivalent of this cell is 1, this is 2 and this is 3. Now since this is MSB and this is LSB, we have 0 0 with respect to this particular cell. So similarly, 0 1 with respect to this particular cell, 1 0 with respect to this particular cell, and 1 1 with respect to this particular cell. See, 0 0 equivalent of decimal is 0. So similarly, 0 1 decimal equivalent is 1. 1 0 decimal equivalent is 2. So similarly, 1 1 decimal equivalent is 3. Therefore, each cell is represented as its decimal equivalent also. This is the two variable K-map. And one more thing you have to remember. For min term, we enter 1 into the K-map. For max term, we enter 0 into the K-map. Let us see what is the three variable K-map, how exactly it looks. See, this is the three variable K-map. Now, since it is three variable, how many squares we will have? 2 to the power of 3, that is 8 squares. See, 8 squares in the sense we get the combination from 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1. See, if you observe this, you will get all the combinations. See here, this is represented as MSB, this is represented as LSB. See here, 0, 0, 0, that is the first square. 0, 0, 1, second square. Next binary equivalent is 0, 1, 0. This is 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. And see here, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. Similarly, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. See, if you observe this, what you have? See, first is 0, 0. The second is 0, 1. Third, instead of being 1, 0, we have 1, 1. This is 1, 0 and this is 1, 1 representation. Because in the Carnot map, only one change is permitted between the adjacent cells. See here, if you observe 0, 0, 0, 1, this 0 remains same and this 0 changes from 0 to 1. means B changes from 0 to 1. This 0, 0 indicates it is equal to AB. In the sense 0, 0, so it will be A bar, B bar. And this 0, 1 indicates it is A bar, B. See here A bar is same and B is changing from B bar to B. If you make this as 1, 0, there will be two changes over here. Therefore, this cannot be made as 1, 0. 1, 0 is this cell and 1, 1 is this cell. And this side we have 0 and 1. And each of the square represents the decimal equivalent. As I told you, this 0, 0, 0, the decimal equivalent of that is 0. So similarly, 0, 0, 1, decimal equivalent of that is 1. See, if you observe, this is 0, 1, 2, 3, this is 4, 5, 6, 7. This is how the 3 variable Karnaugh map is represented. Similarly, we will see what is 4 variable Karnaugh map. It is the representation of 4 variable Karnaugh map. As we have seen, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. This side it is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. And in 4 variable Karnaugh map, 2 to the power of 4, 16. So there are 16 cells. And also I told you for min term, we have to enter 1 into the K map. For max term, we have to enter 0 into the K map. See here, this side is MSP and this side is LSP. 0, 0, 0, 0, this represents 0 equivalent. So similarly, 0, 0, 0, 1, it is 1. 0, 0, 1, 0 is 2. 0, 0, 1, 1 is 3. So similarly, we have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So all 16 cells are represented, that is from 0 to 15. So all these numbers which are there within the square, they are the decimal equivalent of that particular cell. And these are the binary weightages of that particular W and X. And this is with respect to Y and Z. We will see how to solve or how to minimize using the Karnaugh map. The example says here, simplify the following 3 variable equation. So what is it? It is y is equal to f of abc sigma 0, 1, 4, 5. So when we have the min term list like this, the first step we need to do is, we have to enter all this into the K map. See, 0 is entered over here. This is 1. 1 is entered over here. Next, 4 is 1 and then 5. So all these min term list which are present or which are given in the problem are to be entered into the K map. That is the first step. The second step is, we have to make the group of 1s. The group of the 1s can be in the power of 2. So 2 to the power of 1 we can group, 2 1s, 2 to the power of 2 we can group, 4 1s, 2 to the power of 3 we can group, 8 1s. Similarly, 2 to the power of 4 we can group, 16 1s and so on. And always we need to group the maximum number of 1s possible. So diagonally grouping the 1s is not permitted. Only we have to group either horizontally or vertically. We have to see the adjacent cells and group the 1s together. See, for example here, 1, 1 is present over here and 1, 1 is present over here. We can have the group of these two 1s and we can have the group of these two 1s. After grouping, we need to write the expression for each of the group. Now, how to write the expression? See, here we have represented as AB. Here we have represented as C. So, this is MSB and this is LSB. If I have to write the expression for this, then I need to consider this and I need to consider 0. Because this group is covering this and this. And you have to remember, whenever there is a change occurring with respect to any of the variable that need not be considered into the expression. For example, here C is changing from 0 to 1. In the expression, it need not be considered. So here we have this side 0, 0 and the expression of this becomes A bar B bar. Similarly, when you write the expression for this, here 0, 1 and we have 1, 0 here. 0, 1 is changing and 1, 0 is A B bar. When you write the expression, you get the final expression y is equal to a bar b bar or a b bar. So now if you take common b bar, a bar or a, you get it as b bar. See this part we have applied the Boolean laws. But directly also we can get this b bar expression from the K-map itself. Now how do we get that? So let me change the color of the pen. See, I told you the adjacent groups can be looped together. Adjacent cells can be looped together. See, what we have is this part and this part are adjacent. Therefore, we can loop these two and these two ones together. See, this part and this part are adjacent. So even the top and the bottom part are also adjacent. So wherever there is a logical adjacency, then we can group all those ones together. And always, anytime we have to group, we have to consider the maximum number of ones which we can group. Now, when you consider this as this and this together as one group, you need to write a single expression using this. See here, this side we are getting 0, 0 here and 1, 0 here with respect to this group. So what is changing over here? This is A bar B bar and this is A B bar. A bar is changing from this is changing from A bar to A, whereas this is remaining as it is as constant. So along horizontal side we get the expression as B bar. If you consider this, the C is changing from 0 to 1. So wherever there is a change occurring, then you need not have to consider that particular variable into the expression. So since this B bar is not changing, therefore the Boolean expression of this becomes B bar. So which is same as this. So this B bar directly we have obtained from the K-map by grouping the maximum number of ones which have the logical adjacency. We will see one more example. Read the example. Simplify the following three variable equation. G is equal to f of x, y, z equal to sigma of 0, 2, 3, 7. And remember, this sigma indicates the min term list and pi indicates the max term list. So here the ones are entered, 0 for 0, 1 is entered over here for 2, 1 is entered, 3, 1 is entered and for 7 also 1 is entered. Now we need to group. So how do we group it? So we have this as one group, this as another group and this as the third group. After we group, we need to write the expression for each of the group. So you see this, what is the expression for this group? The expression for this group is here. So this is xy, this is with respect to x, this is with respect to y, similarly xy, which is changing, y is changing over here, whereas x is as it is, so this is x bar and z is, it is not changing, only 0 we have, x bar and z bar. Now write the expression for this group. So here we have 0, 1, z is changing from 0 to 1. So for that group it is x bar and y. for this group. See, this is 0, 1, 1, 1. X is changing from 0 to 1, whereas Y is as it is. And this side we have Z. Therefore, we have the expression as Z. So, here you need to know the prime implicant. So, all these are prime implicants. This is one prime implicant. This is one prime implicant. And this is another prime implicant. A prime implicant is a group of minterms that cannot be combined with any other minterm or group. That is the definition of the prime implicant. See here, with respect to this prime implicant, that is 0 to prime implicant, we have x bar, z bar. So similarly, we have with respect to this prime implicant, the expression as x bar y. And with respect to this prime implicant, we have the expression as YZ. So now what is a prime implicant? As I told you, a prime implicant is a group of minterm that cannot be combined with any other minterm or the groups. And what is the essential prime implicant? So essential prime implicant is nothing but, it is a prime implicant in which one or more minterms are unique. See, now you consider this group. So for this particular group 0, 2, we have this one as the unique one. So this one is unique for the group 0, 2. So similarly, for this particular group, 7 is unique. But whereas for this group, none of the ones are unique, because this one is already covered in this, and this one is already covered in this. Since we have a unique one with respect to this group and with respect to this group, these two are known as the essential prime implicants EPI. So this is also EPI and this is also EPI, whereas this is PI. Now when we write the expression, we need to consider the EPI. So what you have to remember here is, the essential prime implicant is a prime implicant in which one or more minterms are unique. Therefore, the expression of this becomes G is equal to f of x, y, z, which is equal to, so this is EPI and this is EPI, x bar, z bar or yz. We need to consider only the essential prime implicants when we write the expression. Coming to the next problem, we just read this problem. Simplify the following three variable equation. D is equal to f of x, y, z equal to sigma of 0 to 4, 6. Now enter all this into the K-map. This is MSB side. This is LSB side. We have 0. This is 2. This is 4. And this is 6. Now I told you, always we need to consider the maximum number of the ones available when we group the ones. See here, these ones, all four together, can be grouped. Now what is the expression for this? D is equal to, see, all these will cancel out because they appear with the original term as well as the variable, and we get D is equal to only as z bar, because z is 0 over here, and we get d is equal to z bar, and this is the essential prime implicant EPI. Remember, always we need to group the maximum number of ones possible, and all the ones should be in the power of 2. So we can group 2, we can group 4, we can group 8, we can group 16, and so on. Now consider this. What is this? Simplify the following three variable equation. Q is equal to f of abc sigma 1, 2, 3, 6, 7. Now how can we group this? First step is we need to mark all these min terms into the K map. They are already marked. 1 is there, 2 is there, 3 is marked, 6 is marked and 7 is marked. Now group these 4 as one group and these 2 as another group. Write the expression for each of the group. We have this side as the MSB and this side as LSB. See, A is changing, B is not changing, therefore it is B. Whereas C is changing from 0 to 1, that is for this particular group, we get only the expression as B. Similarly, for this, here B is changing from 0 to 1, you see A bar and C. Therefore, the final expression is Q is equal to B or A bar C. Let us consider the next example. Simplify the following three variable equation given as J is equal to F of XYZ equal to sigma 0, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 7. What is the first step? First step is to mark, as usual, we have to mark all the ones into the K map. This is with respect to 0, then 2, then 3, then 4, 5 and 7. Next, we need to group. So, we can group this, we can group this, we can group these two. We can group these two and also this. And also this cell and this cell are logically adjacent. Therefore, this group is also possible. Now go on writing the expression for each of the group. The first one is we have the cell as 0, 2. For 0, 2 cell, what is the expression? See here, the expression is x is not changing whereas y is changing. So x bar and here we have z bar. For the second group, for second prime implicant 0, 4, that is this is 0 and this is 0, 0, 4. What is the expression? The expression is, you have to consider this and this. X is changing whereas Y is not changing. Therefore, Y bar, Z bar. This side it is 0, therefore Z bar. Similarly, for third one, it is 2 and 3. That is this group. Z is changing and here there is a single column. It is equal to X bar Y. For fourth one, 3, 7, that is this one. See here, x is changing whereas y is not changing and z is as it is. Therefore, for 3, 7, we get it as yz. For fifth, this column, this group, 4, 5, what will be the expression? If you follow the same procedure, it is x, y bar. And for this group, it is equal to x z. For 5, 7, x is not changing and z is also 1. Therefore, we get it as x z. So, all these are the prime implicants. Now, we have to pick the prime implicant either 02 or 004 to cover the minterm 0. See, this is the minterm 0. This is the minterm 0. So, this 0 is covered in 02 as well as 04. So, we have to select a prime implicant either 02 or 04 to cover the minterm 0. So, all the minterms are to be covered at least in one of the group. Therefore, we get two different equations for this. So, let us see how we get the two different equations. It is the same problem. The ones have been entered over here. So, what we can do is, we can group these two. We can group these two and we can group these two. Therefore, the first simplified expression can be written as J is equal to the expression for all these three together. That is, the expression for 02, we have written it as X bar Z bar. So, this is X bar Z bar, or the expression for 37 is YZ. Or the expression for 4, 5, we have written it as XY bar. Or XY bar. So, this is one solution for that particular problem. So, we need not have to group this 2 and 3 because these two ones are already covered in one of the group, and these will become the essential prime implicants. Therefore, we get the expression like this. Similarly, by considering the other type of grouping, that is, this is one group, this is one group, and this is another group, we can write the expression for this as, so we have to consider the expression for 04, 2, 3 and 5, 7. We can write it as J is equal to Y bar Z bar or X bar Y or X, Z. This is another simplified expression. So, this is how we can simplify using Carnot map. We have studied a three variable Carnot map with the various examples. Now, in the next session, we will see the four variable K map. Thank you.